We should know how to handle, not only how to handle the success, how to handle the failures. Particularly you are in the management environment, Wharton. I want the young people to understand how to manage the failure. Because any task you do, you have to come across problem. Problem should not become the captain of the individual or the project chief. The project chief should become the captain of the problems and defeat the problem and succeed. Learning gives creativity. Creativity leads to thinking. Thinking provides knowledge. Knowledge makes you great.
History has proven that those who dare to imagine the impossible are the ones who break all the human limitations. In every field of human endeavor, whether science, medicine, sports, arts or technology, the names of the people who imagine the impossible are engraved in our history. By breaking the limits of their imagination, they change the world. You take C.V. Raman, you take Newton, you take Einstein, you take Chandrasekhar, by breaking the limits of their imagination, they change the world. If you want to be discoverers, if you want to be innovators, I am going to give you what type of characteristic you must have. Invention and discoveries have emanated from creative minds that have been constantly working and imagining the outcome. The telephone, he was imagining the outcome in the mind. With imagining and constant effort, all the forces of the universe work for that inspired mind, thereby leading to invention, discoveries.
Sir, I would like to hear from you a few tips for the upcoming generation to succeed in life.
Well, succeeding in life, I have already told you.
Yes, sir.
You all have to do 4 things, okay? Number 1, great aim.
Great aim.
I will have great aim.
I will have great aim.
I will continuously acquire knowledge.
Continuously acquire knowledge.
Oh, I will do hard work.
I will do hard work.
I will persevere.
I will persevere.
And succeed.
And succeed.
Okay, that's the mantra.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
You have many accomplishments. You've written books. You've served as president. You're an aerospace engineer. You've been a professor. But you say the title you like best is the title of teacher. Why is that?
You know, I had a teacher when I was a young boy, 10 years boy, wartime, the Second World War going on. At that time, I used to see in my class, fifth class teacher, in science teacher, he entered the classroom and we used to see the radiation of knowledge from him. When he enters the classroom, my teacher, I see radiation of purity of life. And the way he taught, my dream got shaped. What should be my way of life? He is the person, the teacher gave me the vision of my life when I was a young fellow. Now a teacher has got a fantastic opportunity to grow minds, to enrich the minds, and give the dreams to the young people, and nurture the dreams with them, and they will become a great human being. Sometime they will become better than you, but better than the teacher. So that opportunity you have. I will have great aim. I will continuously acquire knowledge. Oh, I will do hard work. I will persevere and succeed.